The default alert on Streamlabs and StreamElements are great for starting out. Pick an animated image, set your text, maybe sound, bam, done. But have you ever wondered if you can create your own custom Twitch alerts and redeems? How about your own chatbot? You can do this and more with Streamer.bot. Let's go through this together. As usual, the first step is to download Streamer.bot. Link in the description, yada yada. Extract the zip file anywhere you like except—
oh my god, not the desktop folder.
Seriously, you probably don't want that. Now let's connect this to OBS, so go ahead and launch it. I'll start from scratch with the fresh installation of OBS. Go to Tools, WebSocket Server Settings, and enable the Enable WebSocket Server setting. You'll probably be asked by Windows about security stuff, so go ahead and allow this. Click OK for now, and let's switch to Streamer.bot. Go to the Stream Apps tab, then OBS, which will probably be selected by default. Right-click on this white area and click on Add. Name this connection anything you want. For this version, you'll probably want to set this to V5 if you're watching this video in 2024. Oh wait, right, there's no way you're watching this in 1985. Take note of the port so that it matches the setting in OBS. There's a password field here. Go back to OBS, WebSocket Server Settings, and click on Show Connect Info to see the password. Copy it using this button. Or you can also note it down with pen and paper, but that's absolutely up to you. Also, if you're doing this live or while recording, you'll probably want to blur these details out so nobody halfway around the world can control your stream. Go back to Streamer.bot and paste this on the password field. You'll also probably want to enable auto connect on startup and reconnect on disconnect so you don't have to manually connect this every time you launch Streamer.bot. Click OK. In this step, since you just added this connection, right-click on this connection and click Connect. This indicator should turn green. You'll also see your current scene, stream status, and a list of your sources in this scene. If for some reason your OBS WebSocket server password goes public, just go back to OBS and regenerate a password and paste it back in Streamer.bot. You will have to keep Streamer.bot open while you're streaming. We're now done with the setup of Streamer.bot's connection to OBS. Next, let's connect our Twitch account to Streamer.bot. Go to the Platforms tab, Twitch, then the Accounts tab. Click on the Broadcaster Accounts Login button. You'll be sent to your browser where Twitch will ask you if you want to connect to Streamer.bot. If this is your streaming account, click Allow. If for some reason this is another account or another browser, just copy the URL, launch the browser with your Twitch account, paste the copied URL, and click Allow. You'll see your info pop up in Broadcaster Account. If you have a bot or secondary Twitch account to replace Nightbot or StreamElements, do the same for the bot account. Streamer.bot and Twitch, done. Oh, and you can also do this with YouTube if you stream on it. Now let's make our first command. Chat commands usually start with exclamation, so let's do just that. Go to the Commands tab, right-click, Add. Name this command and type in the command you want. I'll name this my first command and use exclamation first. For now, leave everything else by default, like the ignore bot account setting. Streamer.bot will already be able to receive this command, but it won't do anything just yet. Go to the Actions tab, right-click on the Actions area, add, name it. I'll name this, I don't know. Next, right-click on the Triggers area, select Core, Commands, Command Triggered. Select your newly created command here and click OK. In the Sub-Actions area, right-click OBS Streaming, State, Stop. Great! So now, when anybody types first in chat, your stream ends. That's what we wanted, right?
What?
Oh wait, I just remembered that my sense of humor is gone. Right-click on this new sub-action and delete it. You know what? Let's just change this whole thing so it makes sense. Right-click your action, edit it, rename it to Socials List. In sub-actions, right-click Twitch, Chat, Send Message to Channel. Put your list of socials here. Oh, and remember to change the preferred account to Broadcaster if you don't have a bot or didn't set one. To complete this change, go to commands, right-click your first command, edit, rename this, and maybe change the command to exclamation socials or something. Try and spam it if you want. Oh, and if you're taking this suggestion, make sure you haven't set any auto mod that may get yourself banned from your own channel if that's even possible. You can also accept commands on YouTube. Go to command and edit your command to include messages from YouTube. Go to actions, select your action, right click on the sub actions area, select YouTube, send message to channel. Put your socials here and remember to set your preferred account to broadcaster or bot. You get the point. You can now reply with your bot or yourself to questions about socials, schedules, events, and anything you may not want to answer repetitively in your stream. But I'm pretty sure you've also seen those commands which trigger things on the stream overlay, right? Make something appear on stream, play a sound effect, and so on. We'll do the command version now and tackle how to do it through Twitch redeems or channel rewards later. First, let's get a graphic or a GIF, a GIF, GIF, whatever. You can debate about it freely in the comments. Anyway, we'll make it appear for 5 seconds, then disappear again after that. Add it to your scene in OBS. Then go back to the commands tab, right click, add, name it super, and add in the exclamation super command. Go to actions to add an action and name it. I'll name it something will happen here. Make this action respond to your command by going to triggers, right click, and again, core commands, command triggered. Then select your command for this action. Then finally in sub actions, let's add OBS, set source visibility state, select your scene and your source, and select the visible state. This will make your source appear every time the command is used, but we still have to make it disappear after a few seconds so it can be used again. Add another source visibility sub-action and this time set it to hidden. But this will make it look like nothing's happening because it's getting hidden almost immediately after it appears. So we'll have to add a delay. Right-click, core, delay, and set it to maybe 5,000 milliseconds. Drag the delay sub-action between the sub-actions which show and hide your source. Sub-actions are done in order, starting from the top. When we try our command in chat, it works. Now, you probably already knew how to do that, so let's do something more advanced. We'll make the user's name appear beside our graphic. Let's modify our super command for this. I'm going to add a text source in OBS named creatively named, then modify the action. Again, mine's super. Add a sub action OBS sources set GDI text. Select your scene, select your source, and in the text area, you can set this to whatever you want. Something like, hello. But since in this example, we want the text to be the user's name, we'll set this to target user, as it says in the description here. And then move this sub action to the top before everything. We also want to make this appear and disappear, so do the same for the text source. OBS, set source visibility state, visible. And then hidden. Now move your show text source subaction right beside the one which makes your image visible. And move your hide text source subaction beside the one which hides the image. Make sure your set text subaction is placed somewhere before your show text source subaction. Oh, and one last important thing. We have to let StreamerBot know who the target user is. We're going to tell StreamerBot to get it from the user who just used our command. Right-click, Twitch, User, get user info for target, and set the source type to user. Move this to the top before the sub-action which modifies the OBS text source. There. You can include some text by going back to your sub-action and setting the text to something like target user is awesome because they use this command. Oh. And unfortunately, the function of getting the username is exclusive to Twitch and is not available on YouTube. Now that we've made a command, we can easily change this to a Twitch redeem instead. I don't want to say that this is again exclusive to Twitch, but I just did, didn't I? Go to triggers and add Twitch channel reward, reward redemption, and select the redeem you made for this. Oh wait, you haven't made a reward for this yet? No problem. Click on this create reward button, name it, and change the required cost if you need to. You probably have ideas for your commands and redeems already, so feel free to play and experiment. The next video will touch on how to make more visual and personalized channel point redemptions with browser sources with Streamer.bot. If you learned something from this video, please consider subscribing so you can check out my other tutorials. Thanks for watching.